Hey everybody, Star here. What is going on? It's been a while, and I have to apologize again. I appreciate your patience in waiting for videos, but it's been very difficult to make them lately. I am moving to a different state this Friday, as I've mentioned before. That is this Friday, so I'm trying to get all my stuff together right now, but this month in particular, it's been very frustrating. It's been distracting. It's been hard to get anything done. So I hope you can understand that. I've said it before. I don't want to go over this again. And this video is going to be... It's kind of a long one if you didn't notice by the time the match goes on for quite a while. This is 6v6 format. Sixes can last a while. So we've got some time to talk. We've got some us time. We're going to bond a bit. I apologize. I don't know exactly what we're going to talk about. Don't expect this to be the most well-edited, most coherent, consistent video or anything like that. I'm pretty much just going to talk at you guys for the next 16 minutes, and to set the stage for what's going on here in this match in particular, this is Sixes. I don't play it that often. This was recorded 3 weeks ago, so it was a while ago, and since then, I haven't played any, so if that's any indication of how often I play it, I am on a SIVO team, that's a league for 6v6, and I think it's been 4 weeks now, maybe almost, it's probably about 4 weeks. Every single match has been a forfeit, so I haven't gotten to play that a single time. So, not getting to do all that much of it, and this match is a little bit weird. I don't know what I just did there either. Like, I'm really confused about how I just walked past two people who were Ubered and shot a teammate. I didn't know what was going on. But everybody on my team at this point, this isn't an actual team that I'm playing on. I'm playing Scout, obviously. And I'm just playing with some friends. We're playing against, I don't know if they're an actual team or just friends. We're just some 6v6, man. Come on. Come on, man. Monday night. So, this match doesn't go very seriously. Like, the whole time my team is joking, Dasukun, our medic on mic, is like calling the most random positions. Like, he's just making up things. It's pretty silly. Like, he's like, oh, there's an enemy at slightly yellow barrel. Or, there's an enemy at metal thing. Or, I'm on slightly destroyed bridge. Like, no one was taking this that seriously. It was a little bit annoying on my part. The match we played before this one, like, everyone was... We had, like, a pyro, we had a spy the whole time. It wasn't fun. Come on, guys. I kind of wanted to play, like, some actual serious stuff. It's not often that I get to do it, so I was pretty in the zone. But even myself, I fall victim to the silliness a bit in this match. And there's some just weird stuff that goes on. Later, our demo man was, like, getting mad this whole game. He switches to backburner pyro. We Chris a sniper. And the end of the match in particular, the end of it is by far the best. If you don't understand that this match isn't entirely serious, that will put it in perspective. But considering I don't play sixes all that often, I would like to play a little bit more, but it's so hard to... I'm not going to get into that, but considering I don't play it that often, I feel like I did pretty well. This was 3 weeks ago. Watching it back, I feel like my aim has gotten better since then. And I watch this and think to myself, like, I did some really dumb things during this match. I've cut a couple of things out because, like, I'm almost, like, embarrassed about how dumb they were. At this point right here, that was actually very significant, killing him on Spire. There was a scout trying to back cap. Everyone was counting on me. I missed a couple of shots, but he did go down, like, just in time. You could see the scout jumping off of battlements right there, going for the Spire, coming from the last point. So he would have lost there, but I shot a guy with a gun. So congratulations, I did something. But anyway, moving away from the gameplay a bit, I just do want to restate the whole video department. Anything like the Basically series, it's been a while since we've seen the last one. I've just kind of put those on the shelf for a while because even if I had the time to complete one, they do take a significant amount of time. I don't have the focus to, like, work on any long video. I am not focused. I am distracted. I am moving soon. That's, like, all that's on my mind. I'm excited about it. Obviously, I'm excited about it. It's a big deal to me. And that's, like, all I've been able to think about. And even, for little things. Like, if there's a new game coming out, that's just the kind of dude I am. That's, like, all I could think about. I focus on one thing when it's unobtainable, when it's, like, gonna be in the future, even though I know it's in the future and I know it's, like, pointless waiting for it or thinking about it. I get set in that motion where I just have to keep doing, I don't know. It's really bad quality. I don't even know what to say. That's how I am. And a lot of this month for me has just been trying to get distractions and trying to waste some time. And apparently I've been more effective at wasting time than I thought I was, because in my mind, the last video that I made, the duck video, that was like 3 or 4 days ago in my head. In reality, that was like 10, 11, maybe 12 days now. Like, just, I'm good at wasting time. I really gotta remember that so I don't do it again. What I've been doing is I played, first to start this story, I played a lot of Path of Exile. That's kind of over and done with. I am the kind of person that overthinks everything in kind of that same department. And RPGs are one of the things that I just, in picking a character and deciding and figuring everything out about the game, I overthink those games into the dirt. It kills me. It's like unhealthy how much I do it. And it's finally gotten to the point with Path of Exile that, like, I just don't want to play anymore. Like, I probably shouldn't pick up any more RPGs, like, ever again, because of how I treat them. And it really does get to the point where I think I just take too much stuff. I overthink too much stuff. I take too much stuff too seriously, where the more I think about something, the less fun it is. When I'm trying to figure out, like, the exact mechanics of the game, figure out how everything works, that just kills it. The moment you start, like, taking that seriously, it stops being as fun as it could have been. And it's not just an experience anymore that you get to play through. I have remade so many characters in that game that I just don't want to do it anymore. I've burnt out on that game for me, but it's also Path of Exile. I do have some gripes with. And by the way, this is an example in the gameplay, to go back to that really quickly, where we're obviously doing some dumb stuff. He's got Uber Charge. He's with me behind. We know we're not going to be able to back cap. I don't know what we're doing back here. He knows he should probably just, like, kill himself to respawn with the team, but we're just being idiots back here. So, I did waste a lot of time playing Path of Exile, but that was fun. There aren't very many games lately that have been coming out that I have been excited about. You know when a new game comes out, or I don't know, whatever you're into, and you just know life. Like, that's all that you can think about. I wake up in the morning, I was like, I'm gonna play Path of Exile. You know what? I go to sleep, and I wake up, I'm gonna play Path of Exile. That kind of seems, it's not often that a game comes out like that anymore that I'm that excited about, that I can actually have that sort of attention span with, well, I'll just play it for a couple of days straight. But finally burnt out on that. The other things I've been doing to waste my time has been watching Fringe. There's like 20 episodes per season. I'm on like season 4, and I feel like I've been watching this show for a week. It is awful. It is terrible. I do that really badly with shows sometimes. Maybe it's been about 2 weeks. It's probably been a bit longer than that. It's probably been about 2 weeks, but it's maybe about 70 or 80 episodes that I've watched at this point, all 40 minutes each. What am I doing with my life? You'd think I have legitimate excuses on why there haven't been videos, but that is proof there that no, I was just watching Fringe the whole time. The scout battle. Mela told me he was like low, he had no health. Whenever someone tells me somebody has low health, I lose to them. I can't beat them. They become invincible. I miss every shot because in my mind I'm like, oh, I don't even have to try. If he's got like 5 health, I only need to shoot him like once. And then I end up not shooting him. But yeah. The whole Fringe watching, like I was saying, I can't focus on anything. Like, even if I was working on videos, I feel like trying to come up with ideas, trying to do anything, I don't know what to do. My mind is in a million bajillion different places. And even when I haven't been trying to record, there's always interruptions. So, I do apologize. But yes, anyway, I do keep bringing up this point that I'm going to be moving soon. And I really should be able to focus beyond that. I mean, oh yeah, I'm moving soon, but I'll get a couple of videos in before then. But I really have just been distracting myself and holding on to the thought that I'm moving soon. I'm really excited about this. And it is more just than the fact that I'm moving. To me, personally, it feels like a little bit symbolic. Like, I really do just want to leave my life behind. Like, everything that I've done up until now, mostly over the last 2 years, have been a little bit different, but I don't like a lot of where my life has been, and moving almost feels like leaving that behind, starting fresh. I'm going through my room and like getting a lot of my stuff together that I'm gonna bring with me when I move, or throwing a lot of stuff out to just clean up before I get out of here, and you know, that kind of stuff. I'm pretty much just throwing out everything, all of my furniture, everything that I have sitting around here, anything I'm like, oh yeah, I remember that, I've kind of kept this for a while because of that one time. No, it's just going in the garbage. I don't want it. I don't care about it. I would like to just get the hell out of New Jersey and not look back. It's that kind of situation for me where I do also keep bringing up the fact where I think it'll be a lot easier for me to make videos when I move. Mechanically speaking, it makes a lot more sense that it'll just be easier there. I mean, I've got like holes in my wall right now. It's not that good, but just as well, when I move, I'm gonna be in a better mood. I'm gonna be happier when I get out of here. And it's that kind of thing where I don't like to make videos when I'm in a bad mood or I'm like even remotely upset. It doesn't work for me. I don't like to come on here and be like, oh guys, I killed my dog today. It's not so good. I don't even have a dog, but I mean, if I killed my dog, that would not be a day that I made a video, because I'd probably be pretty upset about that. I'm sure it would be an accident. I wouldn't intentionally kill my dog, so I don't just kill my dog and then come on and make a commentary about fishing people while making duck noises. That's not what you do. So I haven't been doing it. I have, like, no good memories from here. It's sad, but I mean, that's pretty much the situation. My brother, I have a brother, which I don't mention often. He got out. He's out of here. He went to South Africa recently. He sent me pictures of giraffes. Looks like Toys R Us and shit over there. Damn. Well, he doesn't like New Jersey either. He hates this place, but probably not for the same reasons as me, but that's cool. The whole me cleaning my room and getting stuff together recently reminded me of when we were younger. Me and my brother shared a room. We even had bunk beds for a while, which were all hip. But we would always have to clean our room at a certain point because it gets messy, and our parents would not let us leave our room until it was clean. I clean at like 1 mile per hour. Especially then. I just pick one thing up and look at it and be like, I'm not sure if I want this, like, put it in garbage. And then it always got to a certain point with my brother where he would push me out of the way and just be like, you're an idiot, I'll clean it for you. I don't know, I was getting rewarded for being bad at doing something I didn't want to do, so I'm pretty sure I continued to be very bad at doing it. That's just the way things work. Why not? And you know, actually, now that I mention him, I could probably tell, like, just a ton of stories about my brother. Just explaining his personality and who he is probably enough, but I kind of feel like a douchebag talking about someone behind their back. He is pretty much insane, to just summarize it. Maybe another time. Not now. I'm kind of feeling like a douchebag if I went on, but I do remember talking about those bunk beds, that there was an instance where I pushed him off the top bunk into a box of toys that was laying kind of to the side of the bed. That's a good memory. I remember that one fondly. That went pretty well. This guy is getting the headshots. But you know what, actually, he told me a story the last time I saw him, and I rather enjoyed it, so I suppose I'm gonna pass it on to you guys now. Now you guys are gonna have this story, which I have been told. He was in Boston, and this is really, it's the cliche, helping an old lady cross the street. It happened in real life to him. There was this old lady who just asked him for help. Like, she actually wanted help crossing the street. I thought this was a myth. I didn't think this would ever actually happen in real life. She has to know that she's a cliche, but she didn't acknowledge it. She was just cool. It was just a regular day for her. She was a nice little old lady, and she could barely walk, so she needed the assistance of my brother. So he says, yes. I mean, you gotta be a part of a cliche like this if it's offered to you at least once in your life. How do you deny the old lady and just say, nah, screw you, good luck on the road, lady? Nah, so he helps her. And they start walking across the street when it's a red light, and she holds his hand, grips it with like all of her might, those like really pointy, bony fingers in his hand, and she won't let go. Like, she's scared, holding on for life. Like, no car is going to hit the both of them. I mean, if it was just her crossing the street, maybe a car would run her down. But when there's two people, you don't want to get involved in that kind of business. So they're crossing the street, and she's walking like she's barely walking. I'm not sure if you'd consider it walking. Maybe 1 mile an hour. That's just probably lower than that. But not only is she walking incredibly slow to cross the street, I mean, that's not a big deal. Take your time. She wanted to cross a street. It's like a four-way intersection. She wanted to cross the street and then cross over to the other one on the other side. So you're crossing technically two streets here. But she didn't want to, you know, do one at a time with how slow she was going. She tried to square root of two of this shit. She is walking across the street, cutting the other corner, and then going for the other street. My brother says he is scared for his life. Like, he wanted to do the nice thing and help this little old lady out, but then she's trying to get him killed, and he feels like this was a mistake. So the knowledge I'm going to pass on to you guys before I end this video, I appreciate that you guys took the time to watch it. don't help the old lady. It's a trap. And with that, I'm going to leave you the last rollout that we did and show you how this fantastic match ends. Peace out, everybody.
I blame Clint.
He's just thought they wiped, awful. Honestly.
I blame Cole.
Uh-oh.
All you do is talk.
I fucking give up.
What the shit?
He turned on his... He turned on...
Why can we walk on this?
He turned on SV Cheats. What's turn on SV Cheats. So.
Yeah. Yes.
This is how TF2 is about to be played.
Oh my god. You gotta switch up your mid-strats when just Spire is everywhere.
Hold on, I can spawn cups and cinder blocks. Hold on.
Oh god, the cinder block.
Please, I'm just going to sleep.
Okay.
I can't shoot through the
cinder blocks. Go.
A spire
go.
On top of her last. So can... I saw the spire mountain.
I still have 19,000. Why is it even spawning?
It's all good.
Oh man. My.
Soldiers in our uppy lobby.
Uppy lobby.
Uppy lobby. Uppy
lobby. I'm up for 30.
They're all in our uppy lobby.
Cosby the soldier. In our,
they're in our up. They're in our uppy lobby.
Everyone's wobbly in the uppy lobby.